When did you know that this was the right thing for you to do?
Oh,
to be a soldier, to make soldiering a career?
I think you're well into your career before you're sure of it. I think I was probably a company commander before I felt that not only did I find this interesting and challenging, but I felt that it was something that was deeply inside me, and I got a sense of satisfaction from it that it's kind of hard to describe.
Would we have seen that in you when you were at West Point?
I don't think so.
I mean, were you one of the rising stars there that they pointed out and said, this guy's going to be?
I doubt it. I certainly wasn't academically.
Then how do you explain it? What is happened between then and now that makes you the man that the president has put in charge of the most important decision of his presidency?
I think I got to go to teams. One of the things that I reject a little bit is the great man theory. I think that there are important people, but I'm part of a team, and you saw some of them as we came in this morning, and you've read some about the others. I have people that are close friends of mine, some that I've worked with on and off, and we make each other better. Every time we operate in ISAF, it's that team, it's that corporate knowledge. I think that I find it most important to try to get the team I'm working on to believe in a common effort and a common cause. And then it doesn't take a single leader that directs. It takes a group of people who believe moving in the right direction.
What's the responsibility of the leader, though, in terms of, I mean, you lead this rather remarkable disciplined lifestyle. One meal a day?
Sure.
You run an hour every day? You sleep 4 or 5 hours a day. Why?
I would sleep more if I had time. I would run more if I had time.
The demands of the job make it?
Yeah. You become committed to a task and you become committed to each other. And so when I've got my J2, Mike Flynn works harder than I do. And when I go to bed and I know he's working harder than I do, how do you not work hard? My J3, Bill Mayville, I mean, I see bags under his eyes because he cares. I know he cares about the mission, but I also know he cares about me and he cares about the others. So how do you not try to carry your part of the load and in some cases represent them best or provide what they need?
Join us online at charlierose.com.